Swerve up on that scene. Hop out, engine looking clean. All right, what's up, guys? Poison here, and I'm back from another episode of Bioshock. So, so it's not super late into the year. What the hell? Give us 1 second. There we go. I don't know why my game wasn't showing me audio. I had to unplug my stereo mic, my Yeti, and then plug it back in. Let's see. Yep, Yeti stereo microphone. Everything's still working. So, I don't know. My Yeti wasn't working. Like, super weird. I don't know. That's the most randomest thing I've ever had happen to me with my microphones. Oh, shit. Okay, cool. Yeah, cool. I don't fucking know. Yeah, so I'm here today. We're talking about life. Let's talk about that. Since, you know, February, it's already February. I want to talk about how different this year is going to be as compared to last year. Now, not in like a bad way where, like, you know, it's not really going to be like channel wise that everything's going to be different, but life wise. So pretty much we're going to start off with cars. Now, last year I did a few things. I worked quite a bit and life was good to me. Honestly, life was really good this past year. It's just I made some dumb decisions with money. Nothing really bad, you know. I just spent money on stuff that I probably shouldn't have spent money on. Or I should have had better priorities. One definite thing was the laptop. Now, not to say it was a mistake to buy the laptop, because it really wasn't. The laptop is beautiful. The laptop's amazing. The laptop is what allows me to do all these videos and everything. But, you know, I should have spent my money a little bit better with other things. There's a lot of things I wanted to purchase, but I didn't purchase at the time. That this year is going to be like, hey, we are going to focus on it this year, and we're going to get our shit straight. Let's talk about it like I'm saying. First off, car. So, with tax and with my first event working, I will have enough to purchase a new car, and pretty much that car is going to be another Volvo S60. You know, I'm looking around into getting a turbo model this year, or this time. Not to say I wasn't looking for a turbo model last time, it's just last time with money, I only had enough to purchase a normal non-turbo model. This year, like I'm saying, I imagine I could get a turbo model for, you know, I'm seeing them in the like $1,000 to $2,000 range. I'm going to shoot more for a $2,000 one. My last Volvo was $1,500 and it, you know, it lasted me a good 2 years with little to no problems. The car ran flawlessly in the beginning. Then I got into my first accident back in 2017. It started to stutter a little. Then my car just went bad, obviously, with the second accident because it's completely wrecked now. Let's see. But yeah, I'm going to be purchasing a new car. Once again, it's going to be a Volvo. I want to talk about Volvo. Here's what I'm going to say. I'm going to do another video later this week. I don't know when. Saturday, I'm going to make a video and I want to talk about Volvo. Not in a bad way, but just Volvo with the new technology kind of makes me want to keep going with Volvo. But the thing is, I don't want to stay in Volvo forever. That's pretty much a long story short. But yeah, if you want to hear that whole, section, then please check out Saturday's video. Like I said, it'll be a Forza Horizon 2 video. At which point, you know, I will talk about, you know, just Volvo as a company, why I like them, why I'm going to stick with them for a bit. I'm not going to stay with them forever, but I'll be with them for a bit. But another thing I want to purchase is a firearm. Now, I know that seems kind of weird. Like, Poison, why do you want a firearm? Or Poison, don't you live in California? Yes, I do live in California, and I love firearms. That's why I play a lot of shooter games. Now, I don't get all my knowledge from video games. I'm not going to lie. When I was younger, playing video games made me learn about firearms, like certain models. And then from that point on, I started looking more and more into firearms. And I just fell in love with them, honestly. So, you know, just firearms are something I like. That's why I play a lot of shooter games, just because I enjoy them. We could go this way. We're going to explore around before we move on to any parts. But, and yes, in California, I know it's kind of weird to buy firearms. It's like we have a lot of restrictions placed upon us that a lot of people would be like, there's no point owning a firearm in California. That is kind of true, but at the same time, I feel it's a stupid topic. It's like, if you have the access to a firearm and you can legally own one, seriously, do it. Look into firearms, own one. It is your right to own a firearm, and you should be able to protect yourself. And you know, I'm not gonna get too much into that, but yeah, living in California, that whole protect yourself thing is kind of stupid, because with the way our laws work, I could simply shoot someone in my house if they're breaking in or trying to hurt me. But if I only hurt them, they could turn around and sue me for, you know, damaging them. So it's like, it's kind of worth it to have a firearm. It's kind of not, like I'm saying, I'm not particularly buying a firearm for self-defense. That is one thing. But on the real, I'm buying a firearm just because I like them. They're a lot of fun. And I oftentimes want to go to the range and just, you know, make videos and just shoot. You know, I just enjoy firing weapons. So, you know, once I buy a firearm, yeah, I will be having firearm videos on the channel. My channel is not going to be solely firearms from that point on, but I will be doing videos showing off the firearm, you know, just talking about it, like not really giving a review. But the thing is, if you guys have ever seen any of my old reviews, you guys know I speak the truth. I'm not here, I'm not being paid by anyone to say anything particular. I honestly just talk about how I feel about things. And I'm going to be purchasing a handgun, which I can own in California, thankfully. I know that's so stupid to say, like, I hate the fact that I had to say it like that, but yeah, in California, the firearm I want to own, I can legally own. I'm saying, yeah, it's gonna be a handgun just because, another thing I want to purchase a firearm for is because I already have, a guard card, so I am a licensed guard in the state of California, but then me having the guard card also allows me to get, a firearms guard card. And oh, you motherfucker, you're really gonna do that? Yeah, I'm gonna try to go after dude, you got no fucking health, get back over here, coward. Yeah, I'm gonna try to pursue dude, you got no health, can you fucking die? I'm not gonna waste any more ammo on him, fuck him. Yeah, I'm gonna try and get my, my guard card that allows me to have a firearm. There you are, you fucker. Yeah, I'm gonna try to go for my, armed guard card, license. And that'll give me a lot of money, if I do actually go through with staying as an armed guard. I've said it before, I don't like being a security guard. Honestly, it's not a career choice I really like. I mean, if I absolutely need to, yes, I could stay as a guard, but it's just not something I really like. I don't know. I know a lot of people are like, that's weird. Why do you not like being a security guard? It's just, on the real, I don't like being a security guard, you know? But I have the option to do it. I might as well stay with it as much as possible, especially while my card is paid off as well. And being a security guard, I've learned that a lot of companies, yeah, a lot of companies don't want you having any other weapon except for a 9mm. And thankfully, I do, the firearm I do want to get is a 9mm. But, yeah, I know just that security guard companies, they don't want you having like a 45 or 357 or any of that. If you are going to be a security guard, they want you to have, a 9mm. I know last year my sister, who was a cop, I say was, I'm not really gonna get into it, but she pretty much said, yeah, if you really try to, me, you, and Jaime, who hooked me up with my current job, we could all go and apply for our guard, or we could all apply for this thing that would hook us up with a job being armed security guards. The thing is, we could take the course with my 9mm because she has a Glock. We could all take the course with my 9mm, but we all had to purchase a 9mm gun eventually of our own. I'm like, okay, yeah, for sure. That's not difficult, you know? And she was saying, like, yeah, you could only have a 9mm. I don't know why. I guess it's, like, just a safety thing or something. I don't know. I really have no idea. I know, like, there's all these type of rules revolving around stuff like that. Like, during war, apparently, you could only use certain type of ammunition. You can't just use whatever. That's why, like, you can only use, like, 5.56 ball ammo or something like that. It's some weird thing like that. Some, like, rules about, like, fuck, how do I explain it? Not about murder, but it's some rule about, like how it, I guess if you kill someone or something, you have the body has to be presentable to for like an open casket or some shit like that. That's something stupid. That's like, wow, I never knew that. And surprisingly, I didn't notice either. There's a lot of rules of war. You really can't break a lot of rules. Like during wartime, you can't open fire on a medic who didn't open fire on you. I guess it's a huge war crime to shoot a medic who's not shooting at you. So it's like, huh. It's like all sorts of cool things like this that you could learn. They never have my 9mm. Fuck. Or my pistol ammo. I could do one more like this and start going straight up. Perfect. Watch it have been messed up and I didn't even notice. But yeah, you know, just this year, I'm not trying to say I'm more mature this year because I'm literally the same person I was last year. But this year is just more like, hey, let's kind of just get our shit on track. Let's be smart about what we're doing because not saying I was dumb, but I'm saying last year I wasted a lot of money that could have left me with a lot of good choices had I decided to buy it. Like literally last year I was looking into purchasing a rifle and a handgun. Had I been smart and used my money correctly, I could have purchased both my rifle and my handgun. But like I'm saying, I just kind of played stupid with my money. I bought my laptop, which once again was not a bad idea. It's just I should have been smarter. I shouldn't have purchased certain things. I should have been way smarter with my money than I was. Can I, I'm like, what the fuck? How do I do that? I'm not even caring about her stupid story. I don't know. I really didn't have anything else to talk about, so I'm just trying to figure out where I'm going. Maybe I should use a shotgun a little more. I'm noticing a lot of shotgun ammo. Look at all this. I don't even think I need all this shotgun ammo. But I mean, like, I have it. I might as well use it up. Anything in here? That bitch throw a grenade at me. Hack this, might as well. Nope. Bot shutdown panel. Nope, not fighting Mr. Bubbles. He could stay alive. Don't tell me he fucking learned I was here. Please, Mr. Bubbles, no. What the fuck is this? You invent? Okay. I mean, like, I just saw the U invent, and then I read what that round did. So, anti-personal. Oh, I could hack it. What the fuck? I'm not finding any pieces I need. There we go. I wish I would have fucking saw that before. That would have costed me a lot less money. I guess we can start inventing shit, so we might as well start keeping all this. What does it say? Pistol. Not enough rounds are given us for a pistol, though. They're really starting to test me. They're like, yeah, this guy uses his pistol a lot. Let's take away his ammo. Are those mines? No. We got 14 seconds. So, guys, we're going to save it here. I will see you guys next time. Have an awesome day. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye.